asphalt. So when I first started hearing about this, just first started seeing the problem on news and reading in the paper, one of my closest friends, like a brother to me, Dennis Fleming, is a farmer for Ingles, and I asked him, where is this stuff coming from? He informed me that where it was actually made, I think it was made for some other reason, but was actually came out of a lab out of Clemson, but they certainly wouldn't, the design part of what they meant for it to be used. I asked him, well, where are they getting it? And he said, they sell it in all your convenience stores. And I thought, you know, I just didn't really buy that. I thought, you know, you'd go to Westgate or somewhere to buy this in one of those Bath and Beyond places that my wife may go to. But I got to looking, and a number of the convenience stores that I was walking in was actually selling this stuff. It's endangering our police officers, it's endangering our citizens, it's not good for our children to be able to walk into these convenience stores and see any of this drug paraphernalia that's being sold, along with bath salts. It's endangering our detention officers when they carry them there. This is some bad stuff that's making people hallucinate and do a lot of other crazy things there. They're shooting people and calling the police and telling them to kill someone, and then when they get there, they've got a hole shot in the floor, but there's nobody there. So I started looking at it. This actually is I talked to some people last week. I was in Columbia Association of Counties meeting, taking some government classes, and I talked to an attorney down there, talked to some other council members from other parts of the state. And I came back, and I asked Lisa, and I think Lisa asked our attorney John to actually take a look at this. Also, this is a civil fine. It's $500, but it's much needed. And I'm going to make a motion. John, you got anything you'd like to add before I motion this up?
I will note that several other counties within the state are either considering this or in the process of maybe have already rendered a first reading to an ordinance either similar to this or almost identical to this ordinance.
And I think this council needs to stand up and make a statement. We just won't tolerate this time.
I'd also like to bring everyone's attention that we've already experienced one death in Anderson County. At Anderson University, one of the basketball players has been found that he had synthetic marijuana or cannabinoids in his system and could possibly have been the cause of death for him. We don't need this in our community.
This will get all types of synthetic drugs also. Madam Chair, I make a motion with adults.
Can I ask you a question? First of all, I want to ask John, have we looked at this ordinance as far as how it relates to other ordinances that have already been passed and maybe have been modified? Or how did we come about with the wording in this ordinance?
This ordinance is based on language that is similar to that Anderson County has rendered a first reading to. Greenville County is also in the process of considering similar language as is Sumter County. I believe Sumter County has also rendered a first reading to an ordinance not identical to this, but similar to this. There is a chemist that is employed by Anderson County that's taken a look at the synthetic compounds and has determined what the makeup of this should be. In addition, the state of Kansas has recently adopted legislation that is similar to this, and some of the compounds that the chemist reviewed were based on what the state of Kansas has done. And then it is, as Mr. Metz said, based on a civil penalty as opposed to a criminal penalty, based on what the case law in South Carolina is. A county can't adopt a criminal penalty where it is not a criminal violation statewide. The other thing I would note is that the DEA, a number of these drugs, not all of them, but a number of these chemical compounds have been added by the DEA to either the Schedule 1 or Schedule 2 list. If that compound is on the Schedule 1 or Schedule 2 list, then it would be illegal drug to possess, I believe, in all 50 states.
Yeah, because I believe one of the main concerns here is they just keep changing the name of different things, and we need to make sure we get it off. I've got some communication from our Alcohol and Drug Abuse Commission, and they had a couple of suggestions, and one was to make sure that we do get someone or some entity that has reviewed this and make sure that we cover all the bases for the chemicals. The other is that currently, South Carolina, we mandate responsible sales practice training for people who sell alcohol to minors, for instance. And one of their suggestions was that, that we incorporate some type of penalty like that into retailers that, that do sell this product and get caught, along with the fine that they have to go through a training process for responsible retailing. So I'd like to see that in the second reading.
Okay. Jane, may I ask a question on the fee? Have we discussed it with Sheriff Rock? I mean, is he aware of this?
I talked with him today, and he's aware of this ordinance, yeah, but we didn't really go into a big discussion.
All right, I'd like to get his input from now on, final reading. Thank you.
I'm sure anything that's going to protect the officers in doing their job and also the community from people who are using and abusing this is something that he would be in favor of, but by all means, we'll definitely talk to him about this. I make, unless there's further discussion.
I make a motion to adopt. I've already made that one.
Second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, and this will move on to full council.
Thank you, Ms. Hall. Personnel and Finance, Honorable Dale Stubbs. Chairman, Jeff Thornton, Jane Hall, members, Mr. Stubbs.
Chairman, at this time we have several items coming before our committee. The first is received budget reporting information reference FY11-12 budget. Mr. Jim Hitt, Cole Austin, our budget director, is going to present.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm going to call Cole to look at the numbers. I would remind you and the other many members that we committed to you to provide a monthly discussion of our budget status. One, provide you with some good information, but to fulfill that commitment. At this juncture, we will not have any specific recommendations, but our plan is to provide you with a strong list of recommendations at your next regular scheduled council meeting.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. As Mr. Hitt indicated, I'm just going to go through some of the numbers with you today and then turn it back to him to go through some of the variables as well as some of the steps going forward. Just to give you an idea of where we stand today, at the top, our adopted budget for the general fund for FY11-12 was $81,430,000, which was a decrease from the prior year. Our projected revenues, as we understand them today, were $78,589,372. And just to give you an idea of how that compares with our actual revenues, actual preliminary revenues for FY11, those numbers are $87,604,000, but included in that was a number of one-time revenues to the tune of $5.8 million. So sort of an apples-to-apples comparison, revenues for projecting for FY12 versus preliminary numbers for 11 would be $81,754,000. So you can see we're down a considerable amount from that as well as from the budget. The projected expenditures were $79,350,000 and change, leaving us with a variance of about $761,000, unfavorable variance, obviously. Some of the major sources of those of that variance include our fines and interest revenue. That makes up about $360,000 of it. Just to give you an idea of where we were last year versus this year with interest income, I spoke with Lindsey Brady, our county treasurer, earlier today. And he indicated that this time last year, we were routinely earning about 0.65 to 0.50 in interest earnings. We did earn as high as 0.95 in some instances. And this year, we are down to a little less than half of that at 0.3 or less. So we've seen a sharp decline in our interest income as a result of that, and it is under budget considerably. Additionally, our fines are projecting lower than what we budgeted. Of particular interest are our magistrate court fines. We did decrease that budget from the prior year about $400,000, but they're still projecting lower than that as of current. The other considerable item that contributes to the variance are our fuel expenditures. They are projected to be over by about $537,000. We did budget $1,055,000 for FY12, but as you see, that's not going to be nearly enough to cover the increased cost of fuel expense this year. And of that amount, of course, this is just the general fund variance. Our major user of fuel in the general fund is the sheriff's office for obvious reasons, but that also includes other offices like building codes and planning and any other offices that may have to lease. And then the culmination of all of our other smaller adjustments is a positive variance of $135,000, and again, that just totals $761,000 on the whole.
Can I ask a question, Bill?
Yes, sir, you may.
Gilmore, can you explain the fuel cost on that? Is it just mainly the cost of the fuel? Because I believe that in summer we were guessing a lot higher than it is now, or at least somewhat higher.
It is fuel cost, quote, fuel recall. With our budget cycle, the fuel projections we use, the dollars per gallon we used to get you a recommended budget in April, we use February numbers. And of course, we looked at last year's numbers, but as all of us know, that's not a very good indicator. But then you move forward to June to adoption, and at adoption, we did not adjust those February numbers. So, lesson learned for our budget discussion next year, Mr. Chairman, is that we need to look closer at that as we move toward first, second, and third reading as we go forward. It's all of our folks really do a good job of trying to conserve, but we also have a job to do, and I'm sure Sheriff Wright would be able to describe that much better than me as the major consumer of our fuel in this budget. But we do try to conserve. We have reduced some take-home vehicles and some things of that nature. But when you're talking about $1.5 million and essentially being a third off, it's difficult to really cut into that very much.
Thank you, Chairman.
Any other numbers questions, Mr. Chairman?
Well, you just answered the one that I was going to ask, so I can thank you for bringing that forward.
Jim, do you want to go over some of the things that we are looking at over the next 30 days?
Yes, sir.
That attack existing conversion.
All right. So some of our variables and unknowns are healthcare claims experience. We have a major discussion session with Blue Choice, our third-party administrator of our self-funded program at the end of this month, where we'll look at our experience from July 1st going forward. I can say to you that from the numbers standpoint, at least in the first 3 months, we're hitting our targets as we projected. So it's not like the fuel, unfortunately, what we projected with our self-funded program so far from a target standpoint is working. What we need to be certain with our provider and the payer of the claims is how we're analyzing the claims history as we go forward. The detention expenditures we've discussed somewhat here. Major Urch is going to be talking about some of that later on with the agreement with municipalities, but those guys are doing a great job to get a handle on particularly that overtime expense, and Major Urch and I talked about the new hires and the training that they're engaged in and where we are there. And he encourages me, and I listen to him, to give him to the end of the calendar year and sit down with a real critical analysis, and we'll certainly do that. Our current and delinquent tax collections, of course, the tax billing has not gone out yet, so that's a somewhat of a variable, though everything we've seen initially from both the assessor's office and the auditor's office looks like our estimates are in good shape if we go forward there. Cole did hit permits, fines, and fees, and that is a concern that has down some. Our steps there is to meet again with Judge Turner and looked at how they